Alright, good job, fellas. Good job. Yep. All right. So good job. Buenos dias, mis amigos. Okay. So we got a question here from, or maybe a comment, I guess, from Backyard Gang Barney Fan 2033. He says the Lake of Fire is another issue that I have. All right. So if we do a word search for the word lake, we notice that. The word lake is only mentioned 10 times, right? And then this mention of the Lake of Fire is mentioned in Revelation 19, 20, and 21. All right, and so, you know, there's not a whole lot to it. And I don't think there's a whole lot to understand. But let me go over each mention here. All right. Revelation 19, verse 20, and the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet that wrought miracles before him, with which he deceived them that had received the mark of the beast and them that worshipped his image. These were both cast alive into a lake of fire, burning with brimstone. All right, so if you understand the lake of fire is where they're going to be disintegrated forever. Okay, it makes it pretty simple that this is something that's going to be done away with forever. All right, so in Revelation 20, we get three mentions. Starting at verse 10, and the devil that deceived them was cast in the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. All right, so we notice here in Revelation 19, it talks about the beast and the false prophet are going to be thrown into the lake of fire. And then in Revelation 20, it says the devil is also thrown into the lake of fire where the beast and false prophet are. So we can surmise, if you will, that the devil, the beast, and the false prophet are all going to be thrown into the lake of fire. The devil is a spirit that is absent of God. All right, so that absence of God is going to be done away with forever. The beast is the fourth beast, or the kingdom of this world, which represents this world. This world is going to be done away with forever. The false prophet represents all the false words of, you know, the words that are absent of God, if you will. All right. So you think of a prophet as speaking the words of God. The false prophet would be the opposite of that, words that are not of God. So all of this, the words, the worldly system, and the spirits that are all absent of God are going to be done away with forever. All right. In verse 14, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. Death is going to be done away with forever, and hell, which is the, if you think of it as a sort of a, I don't know if I want to say resting place, but think of it as a location that people are, you know, you think of highway to hell. People are on a highway to hell. They're driven in that direction. All right, so think of it that way. And this drive away from God is going to be done away with forever. There is going to be there's not going to be any more hell, right? Think about the verse where it says, hell below you is moved for thee. Let's see if I can find that verse. Hell from beneath is moved for thee to meet thee at thy coming. It stirreth up the dead for thee, even all the chief ones of the earth. It has raised up from their thrones all the kings of the nations. All right, so the hell is going to be done away with forever. All right, death and hell. In verse 15, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. So whoever's not saved is going to be done away with forever. In Revelation 21, but the fearful and unbelieving and abominable, murderers, whoremongers, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. All right, the second death is, you think of the first death as your life being over. The second death is the same thing. All life is done away with forever. All right, the second death is obviously far worse than the first death. Alright, so I mean, that's it, man. There's really nothing more to look into it. You know, you can write a book about it and make movies about it, but the simple truth is it's just the place where everything that is not of God is going to be thrown into this lake and disintegrated, done away with forever. That's it. Okay. Alright, so I just wanted to go over that, and thank you for that comment. I appreciate that, Backyard Gang Barney Fam 2033. Appreciate that. Okay. I hope that clears it up. Now, obviously, if you have a follow-up, please do ask. And we can continue this conversation. You know what? I'm gonna stop it here, and I'm going to start my next video.